What we're about is being better than the guy across from us. And it doesn't matter how good we get, we got to get better than that guy. And if we can't, we got to get the guy next to us to help us. And that's how you win. We are changing the world. And when we talk about what happens here changes the world, what happens is you guys change the world. You are big. You carry a lot of opportunity. You carry a lot of responsibility. We're looking for you to get it done. Not tomorrow, but today. My name is Red McCombs. I was born and raised in the little town of Spur, Texas. Sharing their resources with people who had less was something that my mother and father did as a way of life, even with their meager resources. My dad would fix people's cars out on the farms over the weekend, work nights or whatever. My mother would help people take care of their kids. I got in the car business strictly by accident. I had a little wayside time on a corporate job that I had, and one of my buddy's uncle owned a Ford dealership in Corpus Christi. And he said, why don't you, instead of going down to South Texas to work on the drilling rig and sleep with the snakes for a couple of months till your class opens, why don't you come and sell cars with me? Oh, well, I didn't have any interest in selling cars at all, none. He said, well, you know, Charlene is living here. The rest is history. I think the key to my success is hard work. I like to work 60 to 70 hours a week. To me, it's not work. I'm doing the things I want to do. And I could afford to go do a lot of other things. That doesn't juice me up as much as working. I started my business career in Corpus Christi because that was where my fiance was. And I got here because the only guy I ever worked for in my life had gotten in the business here and asked me to come up with him at the time he got in. On weekends, I would drive back late Saturday night, get back to Corpus Christi. Charlene and my three little girls would be sound asleep. 2 o'clock in the morning, honey. Oh, go to sleep, honey. Honey, I got to tell you, I think we may move to San Antonio. And she said, sweetie, go to sleep. You'll feel better in the morning. And the Spurs are the result of our World's Fair here, where I was very much involved, was on the executive committee and such, and we found out that San Antonio had no image at all with the Fortune 500 CEOs. But I did also know that the guy over in Atlanta had put the big bird up, and people like me were watching grainy sports 24 hours a day. I said, this is going to be the answer. And the only team that I could find that didn't come close to doing anything were the Dallas Chaparrals, and they were for giveaway because they were doing so poorly in Dallas.
A team whose strongest moment may have come when it inked a contract moving south. And the Dallas Chaparrals may have taken a trek which will become more historical for San Antonio than the first cattle drive along the old Chisholm Trail.
Mr. McCombs, was this a driving ambition for you to own a professional franchise?
Absolutely not. I never had any great desire whatsoever. As a matter of fact, I'm really surprised I'm in it.
We were off and kind of running. In the meantime, people of San Antonio responded to the media. They responded to the Spurs playing, and we began to develop fans, real basketball fans. And it looked like we're going to have a go of it. So we exercised our option,
paid off Dallas, and we became a force in the league.
The San Antonio fans are fanatical about their hardwood heroes, more than 200,000 in just 34 home games.
In your own mind, explain this love affair between the fans of San Antonio and the Spurs.
I honestly can't, Gary. It's so much stronger than what I ever anticipated that it would be. I can't explain it. I can't even explain why I am so caught up in it, but I find myself not only seeing every game, but trying to make certain that I don't have any engagements, business, social, or otherwise, when the club's on the road so that I can follow the broadcast by radio.
It's one of the most meaningful things in my life. It was meaningful to my family, and I will always be grateful to the people who really made it happen. And all those shareholders, I and Angelo get all the credit, but we had a lot of people that were involved, and we needed every one of them. And I'll never forget in that first meeting at the Channel 12 boardroom, when I asked these guys for their support, Marshall Steves spoke up and he said, "Well, Redman, you can count me in, but don't count on me going to any of those games." He said, "Basketball is so dull, I'd rather watch water drip from a faucet." But he came to a game and never missed one from that time on.
We are back at the Hemisphere Arena, and the Spurs are leading the Trailblazers 113-102. If you watched the basketball show earlier today, you saw Spurs owner Red McCombs talking about the cattle sale out at his ranch today. First one you've ever missed. You decided to come to the game instead. Any regrets?
Not at all. As a matter of fact, I just couldn't change a thing in the world today.
Have you heard anything from how the sale's going?
I haven't even thought about that cattle sale, and I'm not going to for about another hour. I'm going to enjoy this.
All right, we've enjoyed it too. Thanks a lot. Back on to you guys.
And that was what happened around the town. People who had not previously been fans, when it became their team, and we always tried to see that we were fan-oriented. And the ownerships have changed a little over the years. But the one thing that's never changed here is the management and ownership of the Spurs really make it the fans' team. And I think that that's what really makes the big difference. It's the only thing in a community that will bring 100% of the community together. The CEO of the biggest company in town is sitting by a guy that parks cars. They have a common interest. It's their team.
You guys have been with us all along. It was really sweet.
To do over again, would you buy it again?
Oh, yes. As a matter of fact, I expected the worst, and frankly, about the best is what's happened.
What could be more exciting in the whole world than to be on the front row of situations such as that? And that's how I've been so blessed in my life. And that's what sports has brought to me. And I will say that all the things I've done and many things I'm very proud of, nothing ever made my blood flow like the Spurs.
Championship rings. Congratulations to Red and Charlene. All that you do.
Well, my greatest accomplishment, of course, was when Charlene agreed to marry me, because against all odds, that was never going to happen. But I knocked them all out, and we've had a beautiful 67 years together. To me, equality is what God's gift is, and that's 24 hours a day. Everybody gets it. Nobody gets any more. Nobody gets any less. And when you wake up in the morning, regardless of how bad you feel you've been belted around or whatever, you got the same opportunity as anybody else on earth. You got 24 hours. Issue is, what do you do with it? And when I go to bed at night, before I say my prayers, I take stock of what I did today. And if I didn't do something that made a difference, I'd get to be kind of hard on myself. Students ask, "What should I do? What should I do?" It doesn't make any difference. Get you a job and do better than the guy around you. Come earlier, stay later. I think it's a great time to be alive. We're going to be able to, during our lifetime, to see so many different things happen that are all good for mankind.